Are you dealing with an evil person? The six signs of an evil person. Are people inherently good or evil? While it's generally comforting to believe that people are inherently good, with infrequent minor lapses in character and willpower, there are other individuals who just prove this philosophy wrong. Please take a look at our products. Our products are the best quality products. The discount information is below in the description. Pick your favorites and place your order today. If you would like to see more videos like this one, click the subscribe button below. Have you ever met people who were completely inconsiderate to those around them? People who had no problem hurting other people's feelings and using others' weaknesses to their advantage? Read on to know the six clear signs when you should be alert. Number one, epikourikesi. The word epikourikesi is an ancient Greek term meaning someone who derives sadistic happiness from others' misfortune. This is a common trait of a vile personality. They are only concerned about their own life. Everything to them is a competition, and watching others suffer is a mode of validation for their evil spirits. Number two, they are resentful of other people's success. Very similar to the concept of epikourikesi is the idea of turning green with envy when someone else succeeds. An evil person can never accept others' happiness to be a reason to be excited about. They begin to feel insecure about their own endeavors in life. They might nod reluctantly and fake a smile at the news of your success, but be very careful. Number three, they are constantly trying to mold your thought process. An evil person never allows you to have a clear stream of thought. They try to manipulate your senses by introducing cunning angles of thoughts. This helps them to hatch a motive against you to successfully lead you down the wrong track. According to medical studies, psychological manipulation leads to approximately 23% of the world's rate of depression. So, the next time someone tries to manipulate you, shove him away and run. Number four, their hatred towards animals. This makes or breaks the judgment of a person on the spot. It's okay to not be a fan of pet animals, but if a person ever states that he or she hates animals and tries to harm them physically, be 100% certain that he or she is a devilish creature. You will often find children trying to kill animals for fun. This, according to modern psychology, isn't necessarily a typical behavior trait of a child. This is a warning sign that the child probably has a dangerous quotient of violence embedded in the subconscious mind. If this is not treated properly, it might lead to serious consequences at a later stage of life. Number five, trust your intuition. Medical researchers have stated in their latest psychology test in 2014 that whenever we meet a new situation, the right side of our brain is constantly monitoring the entire surrounding area to pick up signals. Even if the left side of our brain is involved in conscious communication with someone, the right side imbibes the intuitive thoughts in our subconscious mind. In other words, whenever you feel like something's fishy with a person, don't cloud your judgment with any contrasting thoughts. Never let yourself to be trapped in his or her delusive talks. Trust your gut feeling. It's mostly accurate. Number six, they have zero sense of repentance. Whenever things go wrong for them, they act weirdly. Unlike regular people, they never repent for a mistake they might have committed in the process. They are too proud to admit a fault in their actions. All they care about is to maintain the image of flawlessness. They usually end up blaming others or accepting the fact that they deserved the outcome, as if it's only divine intervention which leads to defeat in his life. If you found this video helpful, please share it with your friends and family on Facebook.